All right, guys, we are going into some absolute madness. That's right, guys, we are playing Pigs Laboratory, Nina in the top right, Future in the bottom left, and units have 300% movement speed, but they have the same acceleration as normal. So notice when they're mining, they mine at pretty much the same rate. Now you can actually spam, you can grab a worker, tell it to move past the minerals so it speeds up quicker, and then click it on the minerals, and you can get more mining from that. I've tested this. The players haven't figured that out yet. They've never played on this before. We are going to find out what Nina on License to Kill at the top right, one of the top Protosses in North America, players made it to many top 8 semi-finals in the world over the past 10 years of her career, up against Future in the bottom left, a younger player than hers who has won some major tournaments, won a Cheese Adelphia over Neeb. He's had a few really fantastic performances as well. And how are they going to adapt? Now, keep in mind, everything is the same as normal, but 300% movement speed is disgusting. Yeah, it doesn't. You don't really see it fully here because these guys aren't getting a lot of chance to accelerate. When you see some units running around later and Reapers, things that instantly go to full acceleration, you are going to be like, what is happening? These armies will be able to cross the map in almost no time. It is going to be absolutely disgusting. And it's going to be really hard to deal with Harass. That you're not going to be able to target fire moving units. It's going to be impossible. If you see like a Reaper running, you have to just A move in its general vicinity because you're not going to be able to click directly on it. I guarantee you this much. Now, both players aren't scouting. Nina says, how has it been 2 hours already? We've been doing a show match, but of course, time is gone a bit longer than normal because we've done a series of matches today. But there's been a few delays, accidentally hosting the wrong maps, players having to go to the bathroom and ad break here or there. It's stacked up a little bit. The Marine walks in, but the probe just gets out of there. Oh my God. Sorry, I don't know how I'm gonna commentate this game. Oh my God, the stalkers are so fast. I think I have to cast it zoomed out because the camera is going to be just wild if we're watching like this. Oh my gosh. Stalkers are here. Future doesn't have any units. Oh no, he didn't build any safety precautions. He has to pull the boys. Now you could get a surround if she doesn't react quickly. That's going to be like pretty brutal, man. Oh, he's got a mineral walk. Oh, he gets a surround. She doesn't react. This is the problem. Worker surrounds are sick, but he didn't keep drilling. He lets her out. He lets her out of the surround. Okay, he's going to borrow a widow mine there. The Marines of the SCV is coming out. Oh my God, this is wild. One of the stalkers will go down. The widow mine just shot like a screen away because the stalker's so fast. By the time the projectile came out, the stalker had ran a full screen away. My Lord, what a silly game this is. This is amazing. Okay, so the stalkers are gonna back off now. She's gonna go Twilight and up to 4 gates behind it. Just the players staying calm and organized in the face of this is gonna be very difficult because it's jolting. That's what it is. 300% move speed is very jolting. Oh no, his Marines get caught, but hard for her to micro her stalkers as well, keep in mind. Like, this is very tough to like get a shot and pull away. So she gets a few Marine kills, but then backs off. He leaves his Marines hidden on the side. Command center hasn't moved down just yet. He's got a few Hellions, and Hellions, oh gosh, Hellions are going to be brutal, right? Because they're just going to run so fast, get in a mineral line, and kill it so quickly. So the ability to have fast-paced harassment units will be big. She's going Blink, which is interesting. I don't think Blink's going to be very useful at all. In this scenario, I think Charge makes a lot of sense because it gives them passive movement speed and like you just A-move them. But uh-oh, Hellions are in. Remember, they don't shoot any faster than normal Hellions, but their movement speed makes them very elusive. And does manage to get a bunch of worker kills there. 5 probes going down, 32 probes to 27. His expansion's down a lot later though, remember, is Futures. Now, Widow Mines are actually huge. He's going double factory Widow Mine. Oh, that's so smart. Oh, Future has such a... I really think Future's actually ahead of the meta on this. I thought Nina might be cleverer with challenges, but you can tell she just wants to play her standard thing. I want to play Blink Stalkers. I want to get Disruptors. I want to do what I always do. He's saying, if I get Invisible Mines, like they're just going to run in and burrow on your face. You're not going to be able to deal with it. This is such an intelligent way of abusing the challenge. And he can run in with a Hellion run by, start putting Widow Mines and Hellions all over the map, and she's going to stumble into them. She won't have time to react. Look at this. He just burrow on her face, says come and deal with that. Oh, her observer goes down to the splash damage. But she does clean up most of the Hellions. How many probes? She lost another like 7 probes there. She cleans up the Widow Mines though. Oh my god, she's got to keep building observers. This is madness. He's actually ahead on economy. She's got to be real careful because, yeah, economically, she is taking a few hits here and it's going to be rough to defend. Man, Future's playing really smart. He's just going to harass her. Now, he has nothing to defend. So if she does goes and attacks with this while defending with whatever she reinforces with, that could be big. But 3 Hellions, that's a deadly run by. She's got to leave some units at home. If she doesn't leave this Stalker at home, she's screwed. Oh, Hellions and Stalkers stumble into each other. She blinks on them. Remember, blink, not that good, but there's no defense. There's no defense. He's being too greedy. Triple reacted factory is ridiculous. Oh, he's going Hellbats because they're so fast that they can just get on top of you and they're very tanky. Hellbats normally are so weak because of their movement speed. I didn't even think of this. I thought he was going Widow Mines, but he's actually going Hellbats. That's so clever. The Hellbat's getting on top. This is so smart. He's roasting her mineral line right now, but he's going to have to defend on the high ground. All of his SCVs have died on the natural. If she blinks across, the Hellbats might do okay. Hellbat SCV. Oh my god, this is an absolute hot mess right now. Nina, try to take down the Hellbats. They're doing pretty good damage with the SCVs. Nice surround, but the SCV's not A-moving there. Bit of a mistake for him. And oh, he's in her main. He's trying to depower her gateway. She's warping in a few Stalkers right now. These Stalkers are going to get held. He's going to hold. He's only got about 10 SCVs left, but he does hold. He takes out most of her production. If he could get a few more probes, it might be transitionable. But he didn't focus the probes, and I think that was a mistake. I think if he focused the probes, he'd be good. Now, if he goes broom, broom, he could dodge her. Yeah. So if she counterattacks, he can broom, broom into her base. So remember, guys, there's fighting flamethrower mode. Hellbat mode, and then there's Broom Broom Run By mode, which is the drivey drive version. Sorry, the game's so fast, my words can't keep up with it. high level code, the Broom Broom, make the burn burn. I'm trying to commentate as best I can. It's difficult. Hellions in the main. Oh, watch out, Nina. Watch out. Good blink to block some of those. Remember, he's only on 12 workers. Oh, he's got to get damage done here. He's got it on 24. He needs a few more volleys. A few more volleys. She's doing a good job of blocking this. Oh my god, the Hellions just boosting around the screen right now. And that Marine gets in. Oh, even more mining. She's on 20 probes. He's on 16 SCV, so he gets himself back in it a little bit there. They're both really wounded. Now, he's got 600 gas. He's not planning to use that at all. He's like, nah, just use Hellbats. And hey, they're not bad. The Hellbats are not bad units, man. They're so tanky. Just normally, it's the fact that they're so slow. I really think this is very clever. She's like, Adepts. Oh no, Adepts don't have movement speed. Oh no. Okay. If you could write that down if you're watching, or someone else, we'll get that one fixed for the next iteration of the build. I didn't realize that Adepts aren't getting the movement speed buff. I think that's maybe after they shade it breaks. Maybe that's what happened. We'll see what happened on that one. I think maybe it breaks after they shade and they're like, because it becomes a new unit or something. We'll see what happens. Anyways, Hellbats are here. We've got more gateways on the way. 24 probes versus 21 SCVs. This is actually a very close game right now. The observer will see the Hellbats. Now, DTs would obviously be kind of game-winning, but she's so low on economy. She's just trying to recover. She's trying to use sentries. Okay, this is the most Nina thing I've ever seen. She's like, yeah, I'll just force field them. Have you guys seen how fast these units move? How are you going to force field them before they get in? That's crazy. That's crazy talk, Nina. Oh my god. Hellion drives around, sees no third. She's going to drop the Dark Shrine. Yeah, great minds think alike. Nina realizing in this messy game, that's a good way to do it. He's going +2 vehicle weapons. He's going to get an engineering bay. He's realizing, oh, in this sort of scrappy game, this is the sort of game where someone does it. I'm still amazed he's not going Widow Mines though, guys. Imagine just running 12 Widow Mines in and borrowing them like half in their army, half on their base. I feel like Widow Mines just running around the map is a problem for your opponent. Not to mention, even because if they walk across the map, they're going to run through the Widow Mines and get shot on before they realize, oh no, Nina, this is what I was talking about with the force fields. You're not going to get them down on time, and she doesn't. The Hellbats just jump on top when she's not looking for a moment. Oh no, run the probes, Nina. Fair and balanced. Let's go to game 2 and see what happens there. All right. Let's go into game 2 of the 300% move speed challenge here. Nina, she was very close to winning that game. I don't think sentries was the right call. I think she just needed enough stalkers and to like keep them spread out, probably. It's on. Yeah, it's on. Just normal XL. 300% move speed. Same as last game. Don't use adepts. They won't work. Same as last. She's confused because her probes aren't moving fast. They weren't moving faster last time either. I think we broke Nina's brain a little bit, guys. My probes look slow, she's saying. But that's normal move speed. That's normal. Your brain is adjusting to the speed of last game. It's disconcerting. Yeah. Nah, I had the exact same thing. Yeah. Probes always mine at this speed. They always slow down with the minerals. So right now, Nina's brain is literally adapting to the 300%. And she's like, oh, the acceleration is so slow. Yeah, and that's the way it normally is. That's why you notice how they slow down to mine the minerals. So you could actually, technically, like I said at the start, you can micro the workers past the mineral patches and then onto them, and you could try to speed it up. Neither player's tried that just yet. We could definitely try this on the water slide map as well if we get to game three. Oh, wait, this is three base, one racks. Oh, he's going Reaper. Three racks Reaper. Oh, this is gross. Oh, he's really abusing her. And that's smart because she picked this map. She said, watch out for the high ground. And he's like, yeah, okay, I'll make three racks Reaper on one base. Uh-oh, Nina. Nina, if she doesn't make battery right now or like a second gate, she's chronoing Stalkers, which is good. First Reaper is the first scout, luckily. Remember, the Reapers don't kill stuff any quicker, and probes can surround them if you're not careful with the micro, but they're so quick. Oh my god, it's so quick. I think she should try to aim move it with a few probes. Just make it really hard for him to micro, because yeah, if he stops to target fire, then this could get really, really weird. It could go down so quick. She's got to keep building Stalkers. She's not building Stalkers. She doesn't know it's three racks. Uh-oh. Oh, this is so greedy. She's trying to get a Stargate? Oh, no, 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 no. You need more Stalkers, Nina. Oh, Nina's just going to die because the four Reapers will kill that Stalker so quickly unless she gets back to the battery in the main. She's basically got to instantly abandon the natural. Not even building a second gateway unit versus a one base build. Very greedy build by Nina. She gets a kill there, but now she loses the Stalker and the game. No, she gets out. She gets out. Get to the battery. Run the probes. Run the probes. Run the probes. Oh, once they speed up, that'll be good. Okay, okay. All right, she gets back to the battery. But she's still not building another unit. Oh my god, she's being way too greedy. Oh my god, the Reapers. This is kind of hilarious. Oh, he's trying to bounce her away from the battery. Very cute play here. Very cute play. She's got to make a Void Ray, something that can keep attacking. Oracle's not going to work. So she's got to build a Void Ray. Yeah, yeah. Oh, she doesn't have battery overcharge. The Reapers, they're getting close to depowering all of her production. She doesn't have battery overcharge. Oh, he corners himself. He gets surrounded. Oh, all of his Reapers got trapped in the corner and he GG's because knowing the Void Ray's out and he's on one base, he was all in. And he tries to pull the dirty one and messes it up. Let's look at this. So look at how close this was. We can slow it down to slower than actual game speed. But he's like, oh, she doesn't have battery energy. Overcharge energy. Yeah. He's like, oh, if I get rid of that before the other units come out, we're good. And then I think he just misclicks here at some point and traps himself in the corner. Oh! All right, guys, we're going into map three. Chat's pointing out you could proxy so much quicker because you can just zoom across the map, get that proxy going right from the start of the game. Neither player's done that just yet. This is game three to decide the series. Nina in the top left, Future in the bottom right. We're going into Fracture. I'm pretty sure this is the map where Florencio built a Nexus here and with the old recall, recalled an army onto the high ground and killed his opponent by bypassing their wall off. I think this was the map. It's been a long time, so this is probably from 2017, 2018. Probably 2018, I think, is when I started casting Florencio files. Oh, she's gonna probe rush! Oh, she's building some probes behind it, but she's gonna try and probe rush and use the shield micro and just out micro him. Oh, Nina, you dirty cheese lord, you. Oh, if she can stop the depot building, that's big. She's attacking the depot right now. I think she attacked her own probe for a second there. That's why it took so much damage. Oh, the micro is intense. Oh god, she gotta get out. She gotta get out. Okay, this is crazy. I don't know if this was a good move. I think Future's microing this really well. Oh, she's stacking. She's trying to do the stacking micro, but he chases her out. He chases her out. Okay. Oh my lord, what is even happening right now? What is it? 300% movement speed. And Nina, I think, okay, she's got the worst end of this. She's lost 5 probes. She hasn't killed a single SCV. SCVs are better than probes at fighting. So I think this was not a good choice for her. Meanwhile, he's attacking her with the SCV counterattack. SCV counterattack. He says, yeah, you want to fight with workers? Taste my drill. And he takes it back, and that puts him way in the lead. I think he's rallied his SCVs across the map or something. This is absolutely bizarre. 300% movement speed means worker rushes hit twice as hard. This is one of the sillier challenges. I told you guys that we were going to enter the Clown Fiesta. I wasn't expecting this to be sane StarCraft. I did not expect this, though. I did not expect workers rushing across the map to kill each other. I mean, a massive lead for Future. He's up 7 workers already. And he walls off just in case she tries it again. Fair call, fair call. Oh, okay, so another thing people are pointing out is like any short range or melee unit should be better, right? Roaches are a bit better because they can close the distance with tanks and marines, right? And stalkers, but Lings even better. Zealots even better. Hellbats we saw were fantastic in that last game. I think Widow Mines as well, because your opponent, if you got like 10 Widow Mines here, they might just move across the map and their army moves into the Widow Mines so quickly, they don't even have time to react. And then everything blows up, right? You know, I want to see just all sorts of madness like that. It's going to be fascinating to see what the players go for. Future is way ahead on the workers, of course. He's got an orbital on the way, but there's always a chance to come back. Now, Nina's been very stalker focused so far. If she could get like an early charge, I think getting out a few zealots with charge, like even just unupgraded zealots, like this could be big. Future's here with a marine though, and she's trying to A move it. Even just 2 probes can hunt that marine down pretty damn well. Okay. That marine being very annoying. The zealot trying to tear down the depot, but not going to be able to do it. And she does have another zealot out, but oh, is he going to get it? He could. He absolutely could. Yeah. Really hard to target fire as well. You kind of have to just A move that. So the marine is there. Zealots can definitely chase it down. Ooh, here we go. Man, that is a very, seriously. Is that Usain Bolt? What the hell, man? It's so fast. Gets the depot up, gets behind the wall off. And a nice defense for Future. Now Nina's up. She's building an adept. She cancels it. I'm like, no, don't build adept. Sorry, the adepts are broken. We will fix that for the next version of this. I tried to test most things, of course, on it, but there's always something that slips on through. Stargate going up in the back as well. Widowmine on the high ground there. Oh, watch out. The zealots get in. The zealots walk into the base. Can they do some damage? They're not fighting the marines. They probably could have, but good micro by Future. Very good micro. Oh, the zealots are getting quite a few SCVs though, so not too bad. They did manage to kill 4 SCVs. Of course, Nina lost a lot of probes earlier in this game. She's thinking about building an expansion, but she doesn't have any units right now. Stargate's almost out, but I don't know if Stargate's going to do too well up against this. She's building an adept as well. Wait, did she cancel her stalker and then build an adept? Apparently. Oh, that muscle memory kicking in. Oh, the Widow Mine. Oh, no. Takes the Adept out. She's trying to play Stargate. I really think Charge has got to be the most making sense opening, right? Charge and just Zealots would actually do the trick so well, but oh, man. This is really painful for Nina, and it looks like, I mean, she was a bit too far behind from earlier on. Let's be real. She went for the probe rush, and she absolutely struggled there. Ah, GG Future, the 300% move speed boss. And honestly, I think in the eyes of every single StarCraft fan out there, Future's stock just went way up. I think we all respect him as a serious pro a lot more, and Nina a lot less, because this is clearly showing who's the better StarCraft player, and Nina just can't cut it in the very balanced, fair 300% movement speed challenge. Of course, I'm just kidding. Thank you to both players for playing this ridiculous challenge. Thank you everybody for watching as well. If you guys enjoy other weird challenges where we change the rules of StarCraft and see what the bloody heck happens, check out some of the other videos on screen, and we'll see you in the next one. Bye-bye.